We're going to go straight into our word. We are in the book of Romans 12.
Verses 4-8.
I'm going to read it in Jesus' name. Just as our bodies have many parts, and each part has a special function, so it is with Christ's body. We are many parts of one body, and we all belong to each other. In His grace, God has given us different gifts for doing certain things well. So if God has given you the ability to prophesy, speak out with as much faith as God has given you. If your gift is serving others, serve them well. If you are a teacher, teach well. If your gift is to encourage others, be encouraging. If it is giving, give generously. If God has given you leadership ability, take the responsibility seriously. And if you have a gift for showing kindness, do it, kindness to others, do it gladly. Amen. Father in heaven, we bless you for this mighty word. We truly glorify you for this moment. We know that, Lord, that is no one who meets with you is ever disappointed. And we pray that that is the same today in Jesus' name. Lord, I raise myself. Lord, if this word is not for my word, but may it be the words that have been heavenly inspired by you in Jesus' name. And anything that would try to filter or change what you have planned, Lord, may it be removed in the Jesus' mighty name. We thank you for this moment, and we pray and we say amen.
Amen.
Amen, amen.
Amen.
You may be seated in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
I greet you all in the mighty name of Jesus. It is a pleasure to see you all once again. We know that we are in the midst of a pandemic. But you have not let that stop you. You've come to seek the faith of the Lord. And may the Lord bless each and every one of you. Amen. I'm once again pleased to be able to stand before you again. I start off always to give thanks to the pastoral couple, Pastor Papi Chondo, and Mama Rachel
Chondo.
We bless the Lord for each of you. The Lord has truly blessed us with wonderful spiritual parents. And I say every time, the opportunity that they give unto us, the advice, the
conseil,
the counsel they give, may the Lord return many unto both of you, and bless you both in your ministry. Amen.
Amen.
And lastly, I bless the Almighty Lord, because none of this would be possible if not for the Almighty Lord. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to go straight into the word.
Message.
The word that we read was the book of Romans 12, verses 4-8. And in this word,
message,
they are telling us that we all have our part to play. Amen.
Amen.
For each and every one of us, for our being here, it is not an accident before the Lord. For there are no coincidences before God. The Lord knew of your existence. The Lord knew of your being. The Lord knew that you would come from this family or that family. The Lord knew that you would also be a part of the vessel of honor ministry. And He knows why He has placed you wherever He has placed you. And not only did the Lord know of our being,
biso.
But for each and every one of us, he laid out a plan. He laid out a purpose. He laid out a mission. For each and every one of us, to carry out all for the glory of his name. Amen.
Amen.
The book of Romans that we have read. It was written by Paul. And Paul was telling us, just like our human bodies, it has many parts. We have our legs, we have our hands, we have our head. Just like the human body, it is the same in the body of Christ. We all have a purpose. We all have a part to play in order to fulfill the works that God had left for us. And in the word that we have read, he says to us, I'm going to read it again, that he has placed a gift in each and every one of us. This is in verse 6. I'm going to read it to Jesus' name. In his grace, God has given us different gifts for doing certain things well. And then he begins to list all the types of gifts that the Lord could have given to you. Which is why my message for today, my message is entitled, God, what is your purpose for my life? Amen.
Amen.
God, what is your purpose for my life? Many a times we hear that we must walk in purpose. But do we understand what that means, my beloved? When we are asking God that we want to walk in his purpose, do we understand what we are asking of him? As I'm speaking to you right now, do you know what the Lord has called you for? If you do know, are you doing all that you can to play your part, to play your role, so that God's purpose in your life can be accomplished? Are you doing all that you can? Or are you living in negligence? As I have said, my beloved, the Lord has a purpose for each and every one of us. And I felt that this message was important, my beloved. Because with the way the world is going, with the way the world is moving, the church of the Lord, the body of Christ, needs to stand up and perform the work that the Lord has wanted us to do. I'm seeing online, we see on social media, the devil for his purposes, for his evil. There are people who are standing up in their evil purposes so that they can indoctrinate us to stand up and
Amen.
Now when I was writing and preaching, I looked up the definition of the word purpose. And it simply says, the reason, a purpose, is the reason for which something is done,
or
created, or for which something exists. Which is why today we are going to pray unto the Lord, and we are going to ask of Him, Lord, what is your purpose in my life? What gifts have you placed in me that I am to share with others? What is it that you have called me for? And we are going to pray today in Jesus' name that the Lord will open our eyes and that each and every one in this place, we will not walk aimlessly. We will not walk aimlessly. We will walk in the path that the Lord has called us
for.
Amen.
Amen.
It is time for the children of God to stand up and seek the face of the Lord. We need to seek His will for our lives. We all have a part to play, my beloved. And we're going to pray when we leave that the Lord will reveal to us the purpose that He has placed in us, what He has called us for. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to go into the book of Jeremiah 1.
Verses
4 to 5. Jeremiah 1,
verses 4
to 5. I'm
going to
read it in Jesus' name. The Lord gave me this message. I knew you before I formed you in your mother's womb. Before you were born, I set you apart and appointed you as a prophet to the nation.
Amen.
Amen. This is what the Lord had said unto Jeremiah. The Lord was telling Jeremiah that before you were even formed, before you were even formed in your mother's womb, He had called him and He had set him apart. The Lord called him to speak on his part. And when the Lord was telling this to Jeremiah, He was telling Jeremiah that what I'm about to tell you to do now, do not let it be a shock to you. Because before you were born, before you were formed, I already had a purpose for you. And that's why I want to tell whoever is seeing me right now, whether it is online or whether you're in this place, know that the Lord had a purpose for you. He knew you before you were formed in your mother's womb, and He knew the purpose He had for your life. The Bible tells us, my beloved, that David, in the book of Psalms, 139, verse 16,
says,
He said, "You saw me before I was born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book. Every moment was laid out before a single day had passed." My beloved, I'm here to tell you that the Lord knew you before you were born, and He had already laid out your days before you had even lived
them.
Meaning that He laid out your purpose, He laid out your mission before you had even lived it. And today we are praying in the mighty name Jesus. May the Lord open our eyes to show us what He has called us for. Because you have a part to play. You have a role in the body of Christ. You have a mission to complete. The fact that you are still alive in this year, my beloved. This year that has been filled with terror. This year that has been filled with sickness. Every other day someone has a funeral. Every other day it is sad news. But the Lord did not allow for you to perish, my beloved. Wherever we're dying, wherever death has come into that life, the Lord did not allow for you to perish. The Lord has kept you alive, my beloved. Because His purpose, it still needs to be fulfilled in your life. Which is why the Lord, He could not let you pass. He could not let you go. Because what He has placed in you, He wants for it to be accomplished. The gift that He has placed in you, He wants it to be seen. Why is it the world? They're standing up in their evil ways. They're working together for the works of the enemy. But us children of God, there is a discord. We're coming to church, but we are not connected. We are coming to church, but we are not coming to seek the Lord. But I am here to tell you that the time has arrived for you to seek the face of God. To be seen in the mighty name of Jesus. If you're in agreement with me, my beloved, say amen. When God was telling Jeremiah that He called him, He was letting him know that what he's about to do, that He was letting him know that this purpose, it had already been planned out for him. Amen.
Amen.
When I was writing this, I looked at my own life. And if someone told me that I would one day preach the word of God, I would call them crazy. I wouldn't believe. But the more I got closer to the Lord, the more I began to seek the face of God, the more He began to divulge in me things that I did not even know existed. And if you continue to read the book of Jeremiah, when God speaks to him, Jeremiah responds by saying, "But Lord, I'm too young." He didn't see that he could do it. But I'm telling you, my beloved, if the Lord wants to use you, it doesn't matter if you're young, it doesn't matter if you're old, it doesn't matter if you're taller, it doesn't matter if you're short. If you have a purpose in your life, if the Lord has called you for something, that will not stop it from being revealed. Amen. The Bible tells us that when the prophet Samuel went to anoint the next king, he went into the house of
Jesse.
And he saw David's brothers. And he thought they were the ones to be the next king. Because they were tall. But because they were short. But the Lord said to him, don't judge by appearance or height, for I have rejected him. The Lord doesn't see the things the way you see them. People may judge by outward But the Lord looks at the heart. So I'm here to tell someone today, it doesn't matter your state, it doesn't matter how you are, know that the Lord is capable of using you. Know that the Lord is capable of using you for His glory. And if you believe and want the Lord to use you, could you please say amen right now?
Amen.
The Lord is capable of using you, my beloved. We want the Lord to divulge what He has placed in us. Because we each have a part to play, my beloved. On Thursday, the father of the house had preached to us. And he said to us that there is a reward. And he read in the book of 1 Corinthians 9. And in there, Paul tells us that as children of God, we are like athletes. But what I liked in verse 25, Paul says, so I run with purpose in every step. I am not just shadow boxing. And when he's saying this, he's saying, I'm running the race. I'm training. I'm working hard.
Yeah.
You have a part to play. Many a times we doubt ourselves. We look at our situations. We look at our lives. But I'm here to encourage you. And I'm telling you to stand up. Keep seeking that God. Keep serving that Lord. Keep seeking Him in truth, my beloved. And He will reveal all that He has put in you. He will reveal His purpose for your life. It is no longer a time to be dormant. And keep saying over and over that the world is standing up in their evil ways. But we also, as the body of Christ, we also must stand up. Because the day of judgment, when it will come, the Lord will say to you, the Bible tells us, my beloved, that when the day of judgment will come, all our works will go through the furnace. And if you played your part, if you followed God's purpose for your life, your works will come out polished. But if you did not, it will not survive. And I do not want that to be a portion, my beloved. You've been seeking the Lord. You've been coming into church. And I'm here to tell you that the Lord has a purpose for you. And we want that when you walk in that purpose on the last days for those works to withstand the fire that it will go through.
Amen.
Paul is telling us that if you can encourage others, encourage
them.
That's why I'm here, to encourage you. Because I also have my role to play. I also have my part to play. And that's why I will encourage you today also. I don't want for you to underestimate yourself. I don't want for you to devalue yourself. Because like I said, many a times we look at our situation and we see as if we don't have a purpose.
It's
like how the father of the house always says,
you did not come here to leave anyone. You did not come here to see others rejoice.
But you also came to rejoice. You also came to receive. You also came to serve. You also came with a purpose. In the Lord's eyes, my beloved, you are precious to Him. Because He can see what He has put in you. And I want to say to you and encourage you, do not reject or disregard what God has put in you. We're going to go to the book of Ephesians 2,
verse
10. Here the Bible says, for we are God's masterpiece. He has created in us anew in Christ Jesus so that we can do the good things He planned for us long ago. Can somebody say
amen?
You are a masterpiece in the eyes of the Lord. He planned the things for you long ago. And it is time for you, my beloved, for you to live the things that God has planned for you. It is time for you, for the gifts that God has placed in you, to be released, to begin to move, to begin to touch, to begin to deliver. The Lord called you for a purpose. There is someone out there who is in darkness. They're just waiting for you to stand up in
Lord.
Applaud.
Hallelujah. Know that wherever your purpose is, the end goal, my beloved, it is for God's glory to be seen. It is for the glory of the Lord to impact the lives of others. It is for Him to receive all praise. When you walk in the purpose that God has called you for, people will be able to see His glory. When you walk in the purpose that God has called you for, He will receive all the praise, because they will say, only God can do something like this. Only God can use this person like this. And I'm praying, my beloved, that when you begin to walk in your purpose, may people testify the glory of the Lord. May people say that only God could have done this for this person. Only God could have used this person like this.
Amen.
We want to walk in the purpose of the Lord.
It's
so that other people can receive life through Jesus. Through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because I see many a times, as Christians, sometimes we can be selfish. We've received the light. We know the truth. And we're seeing someone else who's lost their way or is in the world. And we just look from afar. We don't share it. So that they can also receive their water. But we are praying today that you will be able to play your role. That you will play your part. For they told us on Thursday that there is a reward. There is a reward. And the Lord is going to look to see. Did this sister, did this brother play their part? And if the answer is yes, my beloved, you will receive the reward. Amen.
Amen.
We each and every one of us have a purpose. And even more so in Christ. The Lord has placed something in each and every one of us. Maybe you may look at your current state and see the situations that you're facing. And you may think that there's no purpose. We're going to go to the book of 2 Kings, verse 7. So we're in the book of 2 Kings 7. And we're going to read verse 3 to 5. 3 to 4. I'm going to read in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now there were four men with leprosy sitting at the entrance of the city gate. Why should we sit here waiting to die? They asked each other. We will starve if we stay here. But with the famine in the city, we will starve if we go back there. So we might as well go out and surrender to the Aramean army. If they let us live, so much the better. But if they kill us, we would have died anyway. I'm going to read verse 5. So at twilight, they set out for the camp of the Arameans. But when they came to the edge of the camp, no one was there. I'm going to read verse 6. For the Lord had caused the Aramean army to hear the clatter of speeding chariots and the galloping of horses and the sounds of great army approaching. The king of Israel has hired the Hittites and Egyptians to attack us. They cried out to one another. So they panicked, this is verse 7. They panicked and ran into the night, abandoning their tents, horses, and donkeys, and everything else as they fled with their lives. Amen.
Amen.
This story that I have read, my beloved, It speaks of a city called Samaria. And there was a great famine. There was nothing that could go in or out. But the Bible says that there were these four lepers. Now these four lepers were living outside of the city because they were seen as impure. Their sickness
made it
that they were rejected. But I
want to
tell you something, my beloved. The world may reject you for your state. The world may reject you for what you are now. But know that the Lord will never reject you because He knows that He has a purpose He has put in you. The Bible says that these four lepers, they were so overcome with hunger. They were like, we need to do something. We can't go back to our city because of their impurity. But they can't stay where they are because they would die of hunger. So they were like, if they go to the camps of the enemy, let's see if they will do something for us. If not, then we will die. In that moment, my beloved, they were ready to die wherever they were. Whether it was to die where they were, whether it was to die in the hands of the enemy. They thought that they had no purpose. But the Bible tells us that when they decided to go to the camps of the enemy, when they were approaching, their feet began to sound like a loud army, and it made the enemy flee. And then when they saw that nothing was there, they went back to the city, and the drought in Samaria was over. Now I say to you again, you may see your current state. Other people may see your current state. And they may reject you, and they may think you're of no importance, and they may think that there's nothing left that can come from you. But I'm here to tell you that with the purpose that God has placed in you, there is something that can still come from you. There is something that can still be released in you. The Bible says these four lepers, these people who were seen as impure, these people that the world had rejected, the Lord used them as a tool to free the city that was in sorrow. The Lord used them to remove the drought that was in Samaria. So I say to you again, you have a purpose in your life. To the Lord, those who may reject you, know that the Lord can use you to bring light unto others. Know that the Lord can use you to remove the drought from someone else. Know that the Lord can use you to move His work forward. We all have a part to play in the kingdom of the Lord. We all have a part to play, my beloved. And I'm here to encourage you. The purpose of the Lord, may it prevail in your life. May you fulfill the purpose that God has called you for. God sees in you. God sees in you what He has placed. But He's waiting for you to stand up, my brother. He's waiting for you to take courage. When they come to the camp of the enemy, the enemy was defeated. If the night you think about it,
Mais
if these four lepers were not casted out, would I have been able to be used? There's a question that we must ask. But whatever their state, they took courage. And I want for you to take courage. And have faith and believe in your heart. That yes, Lord, there may be sad news in the world. Yes, the world may be on fire, Lord. But I know that the purpose that you have put in me, it will be fulfilled. It will be fulfilled. I want for you to repeat after me, my beloved. So the purpose God has put in me, it will be fulfilled. Repeat again. The purpose that God has put in me, it will be fulfilled in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May the purpose of God prevail in your life. May it prevail against all satanic purposes, against all demonic purposes, in Jesus' name. Paul is telling us in our main verse, Romans, that if you can serve, serve well. If you can teach, teach well. Whatever God has called you for, for you to do it well. We have seen the madnesses that have gone on, to the point where sometimes I'm even tired to be on my phone, because it's disaster after disaster, sorrow upon sorrow. And it's not like before, in the age of technology, literally when something bad is happening, you can see it live. And it can discourage you. But I want to tell someone, for you to take courage, for you to seek your purpose in the Lord, and you need to look to the Lord and say that God, yes, there may be a pandemic, but I know that sickness will not take me, because your purpose must be fulfilled in my life. You must tell unto the Lord that yes, I may come from a place of curses, because on that day they preached to us about Ruth the Moabite. She was cursed. But you are going to tell the Lord, even if I come from a bad place, even if I come from a place of curses, the curses will not destroy me. The curses will not hold me. Because the purpose that you have put in me, it must be fulfilled. How do you not know, my beloved? The Lord has put you in our family. Because you are light. And where there was generations of the curses, generations upon generations, of blockages, but then when you came, then the purpose that God has put in you sets your family free and it puts that curse to a stop. Which is why I want to declare right now, my beloved, may the purpose that God has put in you put a stop to every curse, to every word, every enchantment that was of darkness, in Jesus' name. You will be like the Moses of your family, where you will bring them into the light, because you are playing your part. Are you playing your part, my beloved? If you play your part, you put a stop to the works of the enemy. Maybe you come from a family full of sorcery, of witchcraft. People don't get married. People don't have children. People die at a certain age.
ministry. Like I said before, there are no coincidences with God. The Lord has placed you in VHM for a reason. And whatever purpose He has put in you, may it be seen, may it be revealed, and all that was holding it, all that was trying to stop it from being realized, today it falls in Jesus' name. You are free to play your part. The book of Romans, my beloved, is telling us we have a part to play. And you don't know the purpose that God has put in your life. But I say, if God has called you to teach, may you teach well in Jesus' name. If God has called you to preach, may you preach well in Jesus' name. If God has called you to lead, may you lead well in Jesus' name. If God has called you to intercede, when you stand up in your prayers, may the Lord hear your prayers. If the Lord has called you to serve, may you serve well. If the Lord has called you to encourage, to strengthen, may you encourage well. May you strengthen well. If the Lord has called you as a light, may you shine brightly in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever purpose God has put in you, may it be revealed. May it be revealed. Paul says in the book of Romans, he doesn't just talk about preaching, leading. I like the fact that he says, to encourage, to give, to support. Because many a time we think purpose, you preach, lead, you're in the front of everyone, but maybe God has called you to encourage. When someone is down, your words uplift them. Maybe God has called you to give. So the Bible says in Romans that if the gift God has put in you to give, that you must give well. But whatever it may be, may you fulfill it to the best of your ability. And you will not be alone. You will have the support of the Holy Spirit. So know that when I'm speaking of this, I'm not saying for you to do it by yourself. That's why our theme is, we're asking God, because He will allow His Spirit to reveal to us what the purpose is in our lives. And it is the Spirit of God that will give us the strength to accomplish it. Amen.
Amen.
Maybe you see that this church, it belongs to Pastor Papi and Mama Rachel.
Appartenir à Pasteur John et Mama Rachel.
And when you leave here,
you
don't care what happens when you're not there. You think whatever is happening is their burden alone. But the Bible is telling us in Romans, we all have a part to play. We all have a role to play. And at the end, God will ask you, what is it that you did for what I wanted you to do? Did you walk in the purpose I gave you? Or did you neglect it? I want for you to ask yourself that today. Because maybe as I'm speaking, you know what God has called you for. But you're being negligent. You don't care. But I'm here to tell you, stand up in what the Lord has called for you, and you will see the glory of the Lord. Amen. The devil does not want us to walk in the purpose of God. Because he doesn't want the body of Christ to function as it should. He wants to cripple the purpose of God in your life. So that lives are not changed. So that souls are not saved. So that the gospel is not spread. He wants so many to be lost. So that they can join him in hellfire. And he will try to break you. Because if you're affected, if you don't play your part, others can be affected. And the perfect example that we have is our Lord Jesus Christ. We know that the Lord sent him into this world to redeem mankind. His purpose was to be a bridge between us and the Father. We have been separated from the Father. But the Lord, the Jesus, he came and he fulfilled his purpose so that you can have a relationship with the Lord. The Bible says that it used to be the priests who would ask for forgiveness in the place of the people. But the Bible says that when the Lord Jesus Christ was on that cross, the veil in the temple was torn. And you were able to go directly to the Father. Now tell me, would you have been able to do that? If Jesus Christ didn't accomplish his mission, would you have been able to bow down before the Lord and see the Lord on yourself? If the Lord Jesus Christ did not accomplish his mission, I'm telling you, my beloved, the enemy doesn't want the purpose of the Lord to be revealed in your life. Because he knows that through you others will be helped. He knows that through you others will be saved. He knows that through you others will come into the light. And he will try to cripple you. But we are saying today, the devil will not be able to cripple me in my purpose with God. I will stand and do what God has called me for. The Bible says that when Jesus was in a desert and he was fasting for 40 days and 40 nights, the devil came to him trying to tempt him, because he knew that he didn't want Jesus to fulfill his purpose. He wanted Jesus to bow down to his power and then man would be lost. But the Bible says that Jesus remained firm. He did not allow the tempts of the devil to divert him from the purpose God called him for. And when the religious leaders, when they wanted to put Jesus to death, they thought that they were destroying his purpose. They thought that they were putting a stop to his mission. But I'm telling you, my beloved, what they did not know, they were enabling the fulfillment of his purpose. Because he was meant to die. He was meant to come as a sacrifice so that you and I can be saved. And the Bible says, he said, it is accomplished. And it was accomplished, my beloved. So I'm here to say to you, do not let the world, do not let sin deter you from the purpose of the Lord. May you remain strong in him. May you remain strong in him. Look to the Lord. And may his purpose prevail. May the purpose your life. May the gifts that God has placed in you, may it be released in Jesus' name. It was dormant, my brother. It was dormant. But the Bible says that when Jesus Christ died, it was the resurrection power of the Holy Spirit that allowed for him to come back to life. And that's why I pray right now, any gift in you that was dead, that was dormant, every purpose that was dead, or that was dormant, may the resurrection power of the Holy Spirit bring it to life, bring it to life, in Jesus' name. May those gifts be revealed. May it be revealed, my beloved. I'm very soon going to finish because I want us to pray. The Lord has a purpose for you. There's a reason that you're still alive. The Lord is not yet finished with you. The Lord has more to do. What you may be seeing, He's just scratching the surface. When you have a purpose of the Lord, Mother, you will touch others' lives. The Bible tells us in the book of Matthew 4 that Peter, he was a fisherman. But then Jesus says to him, if you follow me, I will make you a fisherman of people. And the Bible says that when Peter preached, in one day, 3,000 souls were added onto the body of believers. That's what I want to say to you. Do not take your God-given purpose lightly. Do not take it as lightly. Because Peter became a fisherman of the people. And like I said, 3,000 souls that could have been lost, that would have been dead, were saved that day. So I want to tell you, my beloved, stand up in your purpose with the Lord. Seek the Lord in truth. And this is my final verse, we're going to read Jeremiah 1.
Verses 6 to 9.
Oh, sovereign Lord, I said, I cannot speak for you. I'm too young. The Lord replied, don't say I'm too young, for you must go wherever I send you and say whatever I tell you. And don't be afraid of the people, for I will be with you and I will protect you. I, the Lord, have spoken. Then the Lord reached out and touched my mouth and said, look, I have put my words in your mouth. Amen. Amen. When the sister Clarice was moderating at the front, she's in a revelation. Because she said when we were moderating, that God gives us the tools. That God gives us the equipment. So I want to say to you, whatever your purpose may be, do not be afraid. Do not be worried. You just look to the Lord and know that He will equip you. Jeremiah 40 had no words. But the Lord said, look, I'll put the word in your mouth. And today, in the mighty name of Jesus, let the Lord
Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
You cannot
thank you, Lord. You're going to say, Lord, forgive me for I let myself. Lord, forgive me for I was living in sin and I blocked your purpose for my life. But I'm surrendering myself to you, holy. We pray in Jesus' mighty name. Lift your voice and begin to pray. Begin to surrender yourself to the Lord. Lord, I come before you right now. Lord, I surrender myself to you, holy. Lord, I give myself to you. Mama, Lord, I want to hear you praying. I want to hear you surrendering yourself to the Lord. To the Lord. Lord, I come before you right now. Lord, I surrender myself to you, holy. Lord, if I would lead you myself.
Because you're my dear. Lord, we pray right now. Lord, we want for you to Remain in peace. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.